Hello gentlemen, welcome to today's discussion. So in today's discussion, I will be discussing about the maintenance of the turbocharger. I have chosen the generator turbocharger for simplicity and its maintenance. Well, I have drawn a very simple drawing of the turbocharger. This is the compressor, that means at which the air is compressed. This is the compressor wheel. This is the turbine shaft. This is the turbine at which the exhaust gases are coming and they are hitting the blades, and thus the turbine is, turbocharger is rotating. In this case, the maintenance of the turbocharger, what it involves? It involves the replacement of the bearings, these bearings. These two are bearings. It involves the replacement of these bearings and the cleaning of the compressor and the turbine wheel going inside. Air is going into the compressor via these filters. Filters are placed here. And one important thing in the, after the bearings have been placed, everything clean inside and new bearings are placed, during the time nuts, this nut is tightened with the help of a torque spanner, with the recommended torque which is given in the manual. Normally the threading of the nut is in such a way that if the turbine is, say, if the turbine is rotating in this direction, then the turbine is rotating in this direction, clockwise direction, then the nut should be tightened in the anti-clockwise direction. That means the nut is a left hand threaded. So the care has to be taken to that, and it has to be seen according to the rotation of the turbine. Otherwise, if you do not have an idea of this, then while removing the nut, for removing the compressor wheel, we might be in confusion, and if the normal way of the right-handed thread nut is to turn the nut in anti-clockwise direction to loosen it, when the nut here is a left hand thread, then we'll in doubt we'll try to tighten it instead of loosening it, and it there might be a damage also. So this thing is to be kept in mind. The observed is that after the turbine has been assembled, then the axial play of the turbine is noted. Axial play is noted. Why it is noted is that it should be ensured that the none of the turbine parts, this compressive wheel or the turbine, neither of these two are in contact, in physical contact with the body of the turbocharger while in rotation. Otherwise, it will be damaged. So, what is done is that before this suction side assembly can be, before this suction assembly can be mounted, the axial play is to be noted down. So a dial gauge, micrometer dial gauge is placed here, and the axial play, once it is pushed to this end, the turbine end, and the value is noted, and in the other side the value is again noted when the turbine is pushed from this side. So these two values are obtained, and they must be within range according to the manual, whatever is given in the manual. Okay, so what is the reason for maintaining this clearance, that much of play, axial play in the turbine? That means if that much of axial play is there and it is not in excess to that, that means the compressor is not touching the body of the turbine. If it touches the body of the turbine, then the axial play will be more, and which will indicate that somewhere it is touching, the either the compressor is touching or the turbine is touching the body. When we push it from this side, then the places where it might touch is that this place and this place, and the turbine also will touch at this end. So that is why the axial plane is noted down, and it should be within that limits. And when we push it from this side, from the turbine side, turbine end, then also the axial plane should not exceed the limits described in the manual. That means what? If the limit is more, that means either the turbine blades are touching the casing or the compressor blades are touching the casing, or even if it is not touching, then the clearance is very less, which if it is left like that, then at the turbine starts to rotate and work due to high temperature to which it is subjected, the parts will expand and that during that time that less clearance will result in physical contact. So that is the reason that certain amount of clearance has to be maintained, which ensures that even if the maximum temperatures are reached, then those parts won't come in contact.